everybody, I'm Henry Lee. Today I'd like to record a video for a client in Italy. He's a calligrapher. This seal is a name seal, meaning mountain, Thai mountain. But this is a personal name seal. So the first thing I'm going to do is to transfer the design onto the stone. So when I receive your commission, I will do some research and make some preliminary images for preview, so there is no surprise. At first, I thought he might want to use official format for the name seal. So let me see. Can you load it? Let me show you some other versions I've done. Usually, I do two versions: one yin and one yang. So if you prefer, if you have a preference, just let me know beforehand so I don't waste my time to, if you know what you want. If you don't know, I will decide for you. That's the best, actually, for most people. But since this is a specialist in calligraphy, he has a preference. So I didn't know that, unfortunately. So I made two in-carving styles to start with, and he liked it, but you know, he prefers the yang, so we have to do it again. So this is the first of the two designs I made. I used two words, seal and off, the seal of Taishan, Tai Mountain, the Mountain Tai. This is the name, personal name, actually. It looks more like a name seal with these two characters, the seal off. This is a very common character. And this is another version of a yin carving. This is called the full white. We can reverse it to have a thick red. But he prefers two characters, just the name. And this is my second design with only two characters for the name, Taishan. This is more like a cursive or decorative. The purpose to make the strokes to more even, because this character only have three verticals, so we bend it like that. But he didn't like it. He prefers this one. I think this is more. More matching to each other. I do agree. So this one is what we do. I do like the contrast of space, the dense and sparse. Dense and sparse is always nice. So I'm going to do this one. And don't ask me to show you show my pre. My design before you place the order, because that part takes a week in this case, and the carving may take a couple hours, but design takes more time as usual, you know, just like a painting. It may do the painting in 20 minutes, but it takes 20 hours to develop the composition and the idea. I'm using a liquid called acetone. It transfers the laser jet tonal ink print onto the stone. but mirror image. There might be some stroke missing. You can make it up with a marker pen. I think it's okay. Perfect. Sometimes I got more inspiration from this transfer. Okay, so we'll put it on the clamp. If you want to do this kind of art, we've got other tools, including a simple wood clamp you can get from us. Or you can just hold your hand. Most professional do that also. But for video purpose, I fix this for easy focusing, so you can see better. Okay. And this is the tour. So we cut out the background. Stone is harder than soap, right? In Italian, you have a kind of a stone for sculpture. It's called sandstone, right? That's about the same kind of hardness, and you can use that for name chop. But it usually come in large block. I bought some from art store, but I don't know how to divide it to make it into this kind of small material. I may purchase some expensive tools, I guess, to saw it or something. So, but we do have the plant stones if you want to give a hand, give it a try from our store. And I do take international orders. I got inquiries from South America country. I'm sorry it was in Spanish, but I use Google to translate that you are asking about the postage. It's very simple. You add a stone to your shopping cart, and you will see a calculator. And that with that, you change the country and you do recalculate, and you will get a rate. We don't charge not a lot on that. So it's probably $20 or something to ship a seal. I make a ditch between the strokes because this part is the deepest. And then I expand that towards the stroke. second, there's a lot of debris. I may have to wear a mask. That was a good idea. I'll be right back. Okay, just let you know I'm not ill. I just want to protect my lung from the breathing, the powders. They're too much debris for this kind of style. It takes a lot of, you have to take the background. Instead of the stroke, I cut out the background. A lot of debris come out. I don't blow the debris off. I just use my finger or palm to wipe it.
the rubber pad, because the seal is hard, stone. You need a rubber pad or a book or something underneath it. Okay. Satisfied with the initial imprint. All I need to do is clear a few spots, that will be it. Okay. Like an extra spot there. Use a soft tissue to clean the remaining ink after using. If there's a residual in this stone dried up, you can use soap to and water, gentle soap and water to clean it with a toothbrush. Okay. Okay, I need to sign on the left side. That's your orientation mark. If you hold the stone with your right hand, this will be on the left side, or if you hold something like that, it's still on the left. Okay. And let me make an official imprint. This is my collection of the seals. I have more than 10 books already. So, find a spot. It's four again. I'll put on this last page. Okay. Okay. The ink paste has a stirrer in the box that you purchase in Francisco. The good ones always come with this. You can get a stirrer from our store if you don't have it. The other audience don't have it. You can get from BlueHeronArts.com. This is called the ink paste stirrer. Okay. You can blow a little moisture from your mouth to reduce the grain. Press very evenly and hard, not too much if you don't want to make the stroke too fat. Just press evenly, shake a little bit, but don't move, and hold the paper with your fingers like that because they stick on the paper. Okay, just lift it gently like that, and let me do another one for the client. And this just regular card stock. It's not absorbent, so you just need an even load, not too much. And press evenly. Gently. So make sure all the corners are covered and pressed evenly. And then lift straight up. I can press a little firmer. But I like a little bit dry strokes sometimes. It gives it life. We have done some chipping also for that purpose, to make the seal looks more antiquarian or like an antique. this has a 2,000 year old history. So we try to make the seal look that old. Well, so it's a trade-off. If you want it more solid, you might get thicker lines as well. So just experiment. Also has to do with the padding. If it's harder, like I can do it on a hard surface, this is a mirror. The mirror, so there's no softness, and you see the line will be thinner, harder. Doesn't come out, you know, because the surface is not perfectly flat. It needs some soft padding, definitely. So hard surface will make something like that. And if you stamp on rough surface like a canvas, you'll do the same thing. So for watercolor paper, for watercolor artists, I have a trick. You use water to soften the paper first, because this ink is oily, so oil-based, so you will not smear that much on damp paper. You can stamp on the damp, softened surface of a rough watercolor paper surface, and you can blow some air always from your mouth to make a little moisture, so that would reduce the grain. So you press really hard into the rubber. This rubber pad is available on our website also. Okay, and then lift it. Yeah, that's a perfect one. I'm going to take a picture with that. So it takes several attempts to get a perfect imprint. And you need to practice before you stamp the important calligraphy. Thank you for watching. Let me see if there's any comment, questions. Question. I may have not heard this in the beginning, but it's a name or word from a poem. It's a name. It has happened to be a name of the mountain too, but this is personal name seal. Personal name seal. It's in the title. Chinese name. I can help you to translate to be more precise, to create an authentic Chinese name for you like this, based on the pronunciation of your original language and the meaning also. So because we every word in the dictionary could be used for a Chinese name. For this is like the artist's pseudonym or pen name. You can use any character in the dictionary, but for family name translation, we only have 100 characters that usually are used to first syllable of your initial of your original language to translate your family name. We only have one character for family name, and then two characters for given name. You can use usually it comes with a meaning that everybody's different. Unlike Western names, you have more family names. But very small number of first names. So everybody is David or Smith, you know.
or Kevin or something. So, but in Chinese, everybody's first name is different, right? So it could be very personalized. Okay, but I cannot help you translate until you receive your order. And you can use the website, some other free resource. You can search "get a Chinese name" in one phrase without a space. Get a Chinese name on Google, and you'll find a website which give you authentic Chinese name based on your personal traits. Okay, so I'm going to end this video now, and I hope you have a great weekend. I'll see you next week in my painting class.